Flight attendants, seats for takeoff. Before takeoff checklist.
Brake temperature.
Checked.
Brake fans.
Off.
Engine mode selector.
Checked normal.
TCAS.
TARA, tilt above.
Exterior lights.
On.
Sliding tables.
Stowed.
Stowed. Checklist complete.
Take off. Man, toga and SRS.
Check. Power set. Knots.
Checked.
Meet one. Rotate. Positive climb.
Gear up.
Gear up.
Navigation. Autopilot on.
Check. Gears up, lights off.
Climb thrust. Flap zero.
Speed check, flaps zero.
And the after takeoff checklist.
Engine mode selector.
Checked normal.
Spoilers.
Disarmed.
Flaps.
Checked retracted.
Landing gear.
Gear up, lights off.
Exterior lights.
Set off.
Hex.
Both on.
Anti-ice.
Off.
TCAS.
Checked.
Altimeter.
Barrow reference set and cross-checked. 1014.
1014. Checked. Checklist complete. Transition altitude.
Barrow reference set and cross-checked.
Check. Passing 10,000 feet.
Lights off.
Off.
Seriously, what's with that fucking square? Just one square of Indy covered in snow. The hell's with that? Over there as well. Let's make it more like this. This sunset's pretty sweet. Gotta set up. Well, let's stick with this view until the sun goes down and then go to the cockpit view, as it'll be very dark. that's the Isle of Wight. That little island. Got a bit of a crosswind, so let's hope it won't bother us too much. A bit bouncy, a bit of turbulence. In a few minutes. Just crossing the English Channel at the moment. Portsmouth and Brighton down there, Eastbourne. is that snow again? Nightlight's turned on now. As it is getting dark. So we're going to be making a turn soon. Fly over Karn. Well, in between Karn and Lahav. Then we're going to put straight down the middle of France. Straight to Spain. Shouldn't take too long. I mean, that's so nice, that view. So we're turning towards Lahav now. Right, we are now in France. Flying over Normandy. And Paris should be in the background somewhere. Right. There it is, somewhere. still got a bit of crosswind. It should be okay. Getting a bit bumpy. Should be okay though. Fly through it. We'll fly over Le Mans soon. So it would appear that France is pretty much clear of aircraft at the moment. Or FS Cloud. So mainly the Mediterranean, there's one or two planes flying about, so at the moment there's no planes over France, so that's pretty good. There was quite a few around London and that, but nothing to worry about. It's been snowing in France. It looks like they've just got like a big massive stamp with the texture just gone like snow, snow, snow. Unlike the normal texture. It's so weird. It's like in a perfect square. Sometimes it's okay, it's like blended into the scenery, but it's like all in front of us. Just a square. Aliens have been here. Must have been a cold night, there's no cloud. Oh, gonna be a cold night, should I say. Sunset. Sunrise. It's not wind. It's not light, but it's not over powerful either. So. I don't know on that one. A bit of turbulence. Flippy flappy thing. I like how it also looks like, you know, some of the passengers have put the blind down on the window. It's quite cool. Like some of the, like, halfway and stuff like that. It's pretty neat. Ah, I see cloud. A bit of cloud. Wouldn't it be funny if we get to Spain and it's covered in snow like this? Like, hottest places on Earth. In Europe. It's covered in snow. Now, 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 wind. Come on. Look at them wings. Right, old wiggle. Now here we go with cloud. Fucking hell, this area, France has got a lot of snow. But it is December, after all. No, I won't make it away. Sun on the top. And just like that, the cloud clears. Ooh, more turbines. Turbulence here, Jesus Christ, can make feel it. It's like riding a car with a flat tyre. Feel sorry for passengers and their champagne. Be shaking from all this turbulence. All this turbulence and no smoking, though. Really. We're gonna have to sort that out. Which button is it? No smoking, it's on the seatbelt. Got a bit of turbulence. Can't have you walking about my plane, spilling your drinks. Look at it! Look! We're shaky. Some great turbulence. So the sun is now going down, and we will be plunged into darkness. And by this, at that point, we shall have to sit bowed bye bye to what the fuck is happening with this plane? It's the wind. It's chucking it about a bit. Here we go. Whoa, that's a bit of a bank. That's cool. Good job I did put the seatbelt sign on. It's got an image of like, grabbing glass of champagne, bit of caviar, and all of a sudden the plane's banked. Caviar all over the posh suits and dresses. Champagne everywhere. But don't call me Ryanair, you know. We serve caviar and champagne on my plates. Let's gonna be a bumpy flight. Winds at 66 knots. Direction 247. Oh, what is it? It says 245 on that screen. As you can probably tell, the plane is meant to be following that line, not to the side like that. So, and yeah, it's kind of affected us in a bad way. So, fingers crossed we fly out of it. Like the last like 2 days I've been on this, it's always been a wind problem. Like if it's been crosswind or headwind or tailwind, there's been something that's blown the plane about like a rag doll, seriously. The last 2 days it was like more like when we were landing, rather than like actually flying there like this. But hey ho. Come on, plane B. Setting. To the right, somewhere over here, we've got La Rochelle. In the distance, we've got Bordeaux. And somewhere over here is Toulouse, I think. Somewhere around here. So, we're passing all those in the next 10-15 minutes or so. Our true airspeed is 445 knots. So we are trapping it a bit. I mean, if you hear that it goes silent or anything, it's probably because I've clicked on the other monitor to look at the FS Cloud map. It shows all the other players' planes in the world. And we're using the app. Or app, I should say. And say it has hundreds of players on there, all over the world. And all you've really got to do is obviously install it from their website and basically just open FSX and launch at the airport of your desire. So for instance, Heathrow. And then open up FS Cloud. And then there you go. It's all synced with the sim. And with all the other players in the world. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. This poor plane, it's going to need a medal when it gets to bloody Alicante. An arrest. It's going to be like Casey Jr. after Train Journey. Like, when it parks up. Starry night, clear night, which is what we want. Now, if all goes well, I shall do a manual landing with this. It should be easy peasy. So, but if we're getting turbulence and stuff like that, it might have to be an auto land. Don't know yet. I don't like the fact that we're turning left into that crosswind at 71 knots. Yeah. This is not good. Don't think we'll be heading 170 for long, I don't think. Because we've got to come back on 180 to head south for Alicante, so. Screwing up the altitude a little bit. See, there's going to be another point there, and that should be going up this direction. Yeah, as you can, as you can see, when we get to that waypoint, zoom in a bit. Yeah, we're going 170, then we'll be back onto 180 there. It's not liking it, is it? No, that's not the wind, we're freaking turning. The darkness is coming from here. What town is it? Lemov. Is it wrong? Lemov gas? Yes? How the fuck do you pronounce it? The sun is now set. We are heading £165 per hour. And it is now the night time. The darkness. A landing in the dark. Ooh, this is going to be fun. Toulouse! Toulouse is about 5-10 minutes away from where we are now, so. So when we like fly past Toulouse, we should be able to see the coast on both sides of the aircraft, so. What I'm assuming the flight plan's gonna do is we're gonna fly to the very right of Spain, down the coast and then straight into Alicante that way. I'm assuming. The wind is just getting higher and higher. 72 knots. Direction 243. Which I am not really happy about. the exterior for this too. This plane, I know. Maybe like that? That way? I think that down there is bigger than that, I think. Is that 8 pounds? I'm not sure. Maybe looking at the map I've got, something like that. Right. That in the background there. Oh, there is somewhere around here. Because that looks like the entrance, the estuary, whatever you want to call it, into Bordeaux. This plane, I know. It's been here for a little while longer. Oh my god, what the bloody hell's happened down here? Now, is that cloud or is it snow? It's bloody cloud! Stamping cloud on map. See, cloud should look like this. Okay. But yeah, it's not rendered in properly. That's how it should look. And that's how it should not look. Straight edge. FSX, you're really good, but sometimes you can just be so funny at times. What the fuck was that? We've had a warning. I think the turbulence might be getting to the plane. We were quite a bit lower than our cruising altitude, but now it looks like we're heading back up to 38,000 actual. So we did have a warning light there, or a warning siren or something. So you see, you know, seatbelt signs are on for a reason. There's seriously a place in France called Chandon. I am not joking either. It's spelled C-O-N-D-O-M. Pretty sure. Yeah, it's same spelling. God damn it. I feel sorry for people who live there. Of all the like jokes people have probably made when they're sending stuff out there. Like, ha ha ha, get out of your system. Well, we will be flying over Condom. And Toulouse on the left, pretty soon. In a matter of moments, actually. So like I said, to the right side, we should see the sea. And to the left, in the far distance. There is water, so, and in front of us is some mountains. Scroll back. There we go. So the two big places we will be flying over, or past, would be Barcelona and Valencia, before we actually get to Alicante. So they're the two big places we're gonna fly over, so that should be interesting for all the night lights and that in FSX. But some of them are really, really nice. So. The plane's not shaking anymore, so turbulence is okay. Little bits and bats, but not as much as what it were before. Slightly turning into an Edwin, but we can't do it about that. sun, it's nighttime. Stop glaring my plane. Check and see if everything's okay. Cruise altitude. Yeah, the wind's interrupting the altitude. It's going up and down like a yo-yo. Hey-ho. Hey-ho. Let's go. Tattoo man's on there. Passing over some beautiful mountains, which, surprise surprise, have got snow on top and a bit of cloud. say somewhere over there is going to be Barcelona. Somewhere. Valencia is directly in front of us. We should go up to that in a few minutes. We are seriously taking this flat plan sideways. It's so funny. How much fuel do we have? We'll do it. In fact, I'll have that on. Fuel, Jesus Christ. No time for go rounds. I'm assuming that we'd be burning more fuel because of the wind. Because the engines are obviously doing more, pulling more fuel through to get more power to keep us on flight plan. But bear in mind, that wasn't on 100% when we set off. It was like 40 or something, so we should be able to get to Alicante. And also bear in mind, when we go on the descent, we don't use the engines at all, but it'd be like idle for like 50% of the way, so. Now, if the wind stays in this direction, we are going to get a crosswind on the landing. Not what I want, but. We can see the sea. I have only once had it happen when I've run out of fuel mid-flight. Only once. This should not happen, but well, life is life. I'll have to if I'm out of fuel, I'll have to squat somewhere and land somewhere. In a field, on a road. Anywhere really. But we travelled quite a bit since it said 14, so should be fine. Meow. flight plan has recognized the ILS, runway 10Z. We are getting close, my friends. How close are we to the descent? Pretty close. We are clear of all aircraft, so we should be fine and dandy to land at Alicante. There's been a few planes flying about Spain now, but it seems like they're going to like the left side of Spain, to the west, so not going to affect us in the east pretty much, so that's super. As I said, we're going to be hugging, like, the west. No. We're going to be hugging, like, the east side of Spain. As we're going down towards Alicante. I mean, 80 knots. Tackling it from the land. I thought we were going to go like out to sea and then come back in to Alicante, but we're not, we're going the other way, so that's good. That's pretty cool. Or are we going to be in the crossway? Not really. Look at all this. Look at all this. That's weather. Yeah, we've got plenty of fuel. We should be coming up to double checking everything before we descend soon, so that'll be the next thing we'll be doing before we start doing all the turns and coming round to actually landing. Valencia is just going to be around about here. We'll be passing that before we descend. go.
Descent preparation checklist.
Seatbelt signs.
On.
Anti-ice.
Off.
Landing information.
Received.
Altimeter.
Standard.
Landing elevation.
Set.
Bearer radio.
Set.
Checklist complete.
Alright. So what I'm gonna do is set this to 2000. So then when we get to 2000, I can turn off the autopilot when we get to the runway. And you can fly straight in. So left click.
Initiating descent.
FMA check.
Radar tilt.
Set below.
So now we are going to be dropping at a fair rate of knots. As you can probably tell by the number at the top here, the altitude, and also by this here. This line here tells me how fast we're dropping. And at some point we are going to capture this purple pink circle here. These two lines mean that the plane will not exceed that speed during the descent. Like, the optimum altitude will be there. So when we get to there, that's probably where that little dot's going to get to. Then we're just going to descend straight in. And also when we get to a certain altitude, I will initiate the approach phase, which will slow the plane down even more. But that's, I'll probably do that more towards when I turn off the autopilot. I'll say 5,000, more like 4,000. We're not using as much power on the throttle, on the engines. I think that most of the trip they've been on like 90, they are now on 73. Turn in soon. passing 3,000 feet. Maybe. Calm down. See, the wind is changing direction all the time, so this is the problem that I had like the last two flights. Yesterday it was like a damn compass, it was just every direction going at Manchester. The wind is calming down. And we captured the pink dot. So, get down. So now what will happen is the plane will now try and stay on that pink dot. The throttle is now idle, The plane knows we're in the descent, and also knows that we're following the nav as well. So we're passing 25,000 feet, and we also descending a lot quicker than what we were. So we are now descending at 27,000 feet a minute. I think that's what it is. And also the plane is sticking inside the two pink lines there. So everything is going smoothly. We are going to be turning soon, pretty much now. And this is what I meant by that should be fine, as the throttle is idle, there's no power on the engines, so it's not using up as much fuel as what it would be on full power. That isn't like that because we are having a headwind there, which is going to turn into a crosswind here. And the speed is also going down with the wind, which is very good for us. We are bloody banking at a 45 degree angle for some reason. I mean, it's not like this is slow. We're doing what? 265 knots, something like that. Well, it says up there. 270. Just over. So now we're getting lined up to fly the approach. Throttles are now idle, and it will resume following this pink dot and staying within the pink. I say we have got to really crash out this plane. Got old flight sim, press B to reset your altimeter. Right, all these do, these just changes the volume, brightness, that doesn't do anything, and this just basically dims and lights up stuff, but we don't want to be messing around with that too much. True airspeed is 340, ground speed is 333. We're now at 15,000 feet. Bonnie is damn it. And we need to be a hell of a lot lower. But it's fine, because we are still following this, and that should give us plenty of time to come in to land. Now when we get to the D, I'll alert the approach phase, which will knock us down to probably about 200 knots. Because Alicante is right there. We are now less than 40 miles away from Alicante. is that? You got any echo camera? No? Okay. And again? Throttle is idle, so we're not using up as much fuel. It'll only use throttle if need be. Now that was the wind change. As you can see, it was coming from this direction before. Now it has changed direction again, so the plane has altered itself to compensate for the wind change. Now the next speed. Yeah, because that's a thing. Okay. So now the plane will fly between these two sets of pink things now, because it was up here before, but now we're slowing down. We'll now fly a bit slower.
Passing 10,000 feet.
Lights on.
On.
Now what they've done just then is they have set the primary flight display up for the ILS landing, which means. Right, there's an arrow there, and there will be an arrow on here somewhere. Now what we've got to do is get a diamond on this line, and a diamond on this line to line up the top and the bottom to capture the ILS approach checklist might as well.
Approach checklist.
Beacon status.
Checked.
Sliding tables.
Stowed.
Stowed. Cabin signs?
Checked.
Nav accuracy?
Checked.
Bearer reference?
Standard.
Checklist complete.
Right, it says manually activate the approach phase. So.
Flight attendants, prepare for landing.
Yes, co-pilot, just talk over me, you know what I mean? Right, so we're going to this setting here. We're going to the preference. Going to activate the approach phase. Confirm. And there we go. The approach is now dialed in. So, as I said before, we have got a diamond here, and there will be a diamond here. Now this has to be in line with this, and I'll line vertically as well. As I said before, to capture the ILS. Set that. Not as far down, I don't think. In fact, what I'll do is bring up this.
Put it flaps in. 1.
Speed check, flaps 1.
So we can get a good view of all the instruments on landing. Now the only thing I will be doing on this landing will be turning off the autopilot, and I'll be flying it in. That's the only buttons I'll be pressing. I can use the ILS as a guide to fly myself in. That's what I hope. So the plane is now ready to land, basically. We've got us 2,000 feet altitude set. And we are now flying at 180 knots. So as you can see, the pink diamond is almost in line with the wings, which means that we're going to be on par capturing the aerodynamic slope, or the ILS, or whatever, at the right altitude. As this does change the closer you get to the airport, so it just determines what altitude you capture it at, sort of thing. I think the best altitude is like 2,500 feet or something, but we're so far out it's alright. But we want it to be above the altitude that we're at. So then we'll fly into it. Seven % fuel, we're fine.
Localizer alive. Transition altitude.
Checked. 1013.
1013. Checked.
What's this? What will those zoom? Just a tad. Oh no, I don't know that. Now what's happening? We're coming in sideways.
Autopilot off.
Yes, there's a warning light because I've turned the autopilot off. Now this is me flying the plane. this is bloody tricky. Shut up!
Speed check, flaps 2.
Gear down.
Glide slow.
Gear down.
Now we are way, way, way below. Shut up.
Speed check, flaps 3. Speed check, flaps 4.
Landing checklist.
Landing gear.
Down and locked, 3 greens.
Ground spoilers.
Checked and armed.
Auto brakes.
Medium.
500.
Exterior lights.
On.
Go around altitude.
Set.
Landing memo.
Checked, no blue.
Checklist complete.
400.
Sink rate.
Shut up, we're not sinking.
300. 100 above. Two minimum.
Sink rate.
Dead wind.
Continue.
Helping me actually.
100. 70. 60. 50. 40. 30. 20. Retard.
Right, oh god.
Oh, retard.
Ground spoilers.
We're bounced.
Reverse
we're bounced. Oh god. Reverse. Oh god. Would help if I put it in fucking idle.
70 knots.
Well, manual all brakes.
Auto brakes off.
All things considered, I think that was pretty alright. Get a bit of throttle, let's get out of it. One way.
APU on.
After landing checklist.
Exterior lights.
Checked.
Ground spoilers.
Set off.
Engine mode selector.
Checked normal.
Flaps.
Checked retracted.
TCAS.
Checked standby.
Brake temperature.
Checked.
APU.
On.
Checklist complete.
I have no clue which gate that is. Do is I'll park at the front. turn this. Follow the lines. Follow the lines. Oh, am I actually going to park somewhere where there's actually going to be a jetway? Engines off.
And the parking checklist.
Parking brake and chocks.
Chocks are set. Parking brakes released.
Engine master.
Set off.
Seatbelt signs.
Set off.
Beacon lights.
Set off.
Exterior lights.
Set off.
Anti-ice.
Off.
Fuel pumps.
Set off.
Checklist complete. Yeah. I made a jetway. You come nom nom my plane.